Welcome to this module, Informatics, Safety, and Quality. The field of healthcare informatics is very exciting these days. We are going to start this course by focusing on the electronic health record because this has been the single most important innovation in healthcare over the past decades. Although there may be other more exciting developments in informatics, the EHR has been the focus of the informatics industry since 2004, when President George W. Bush set a goal for every American to have an EHR by the year 2014. In his statement, he declared, "By computerizing health records, we can avoid dangerous medical mistakes, reduce costs, and improve care." The development of EHRs was very slow until the Health Information Technology for Education and Clinical Health, or the HITECH Act, with the Stimulus Act of 2009, set aside money to change how healthcare providers documented their services and communicated with patients and payers. The HITECH Act established the Office of the National Coordinator for Health Information Technology as a funded position with specific power and authority. The ONC has created several strategic plans that have provided payments to providers that achieve meaningful use of EHRs in various stages. It's important to realize how much of the current state of healthcare technology has been impacted by federal policies and funding. In addition to the stages of meaningful use, the ONC has set up a Health IT Standards Committee to set standards for exchanging data and certifying EHRs. They also set up regional extension centers to help small providers make the best choices for their offices. The ONC continues to influence healthcare IT through the Federal Health IT Goals and the Federal Health IT Strategic Plan for 2015 to 2020. The strategic plan calls for increased interoperability among providers and organizations and increased privacy and security of health information. On another side, the Institute of Medicine, now called the National Academy of Sciences, released a report in 2011 on HIT and patient safety that recognized what are called unintended consequences, which Nelson and Staggers define as positive, negative, or neutral unanticipated outcomes occurring as a result of a planned activity or event. The report says that, due to the complex delivery of healthcare, health IT may unintentionally create new hazards that must be identified and remedied. Gone are the days when anyone thinks that technology will solve our problems. However, this situation gives advanced practice nurses an opportunity to speak up and offer solutions to these problems. These unintended consequences have given rise to new ways to look at the interaction between the social and technical environment in healthcare. A great example of this can be seen in the Sociotechnical Model for Informatics that outlines a way to evaluate a system by examining the hardware and software, the workflow communication, the human-computer interface, the internal organization features, the rules and regulations, the clinical content, and the people involved. The initial reports from the Institute of Medicine in the 1990s, called the Crossing the Quality Chasm series, proposed six aims for healthcare that have formed the underlying basis of every federal policy since that time. They propose that healthcare should be safe, preventing injury or adverse outcomes, effective, ensuring evidence-based interventions, patient-centered, ensuring patient preferences, needs, and values are considered, timely, delivering care when needed, efficient, preventing the waste of human and other resources, and equitable, providing care to all individuals. These aims are still emphasized today and have been adopted by the World Health Organization for patient safety. As you use your skills and thinking to examine problems in healthcare IT and work toward solutions, remember these six aims. Finally, I recognize that advanced practice nurses work in different environments and may not be familiar with the basic applications used in the clinical setting. Some of the more basic parts are computerized provider order entry, or CPOE, where providers write orders that are transmitted to pharmacy, lab, radiology, nursing, and other areas. Another component is clinical decision support systems, or CDS. This part can be seen in the form of alerts related to medication orders and allergies, or order sets which providers use to ensure secondary orders are entered. The electronic medication administration record is usually paired with barcode medication administration to reduce errors in medications. Clinical documentation applications provide structured and unstructured ways to document patient care, patient assessments, demographic information, and care coordination across multiple disciplines.